Listen!
What I want to say is, through growing up, what I've discovered is that this world is a very vast and very wonderful, beautiful one, and there are so many things to discover. But the most important journey I think all of us will go through is the journey in ourselves, to find our truth, to find who we are and what makes us happy. And in our culture, we are told that if we're beautiful, if we're skinny, successful, famous, if we fit in, if everyone loves us, then we'll be happy. But that's not entirely true. And this is what I want to talk about, basically. I'm going to start with a poem that I wrote when I wasn't very happy. I actually wrote this a year ago, but again, if you know depression, it comes back. It's a reoccurring thing that you can't really sort away. Anyway. Who am I? Who am I trying to be? Not myself, anyone but myself. Living in a fantasy to bury the reality, making myself the mystery, a strong facade disguising the misery. Empty but beyond the point of emptiness, full to the brim of fake confidence, a guard that will never be broken because I broke a long time ago. I'm hurting but don't tell anyone, no one needs to know. Don't show who you failed, always okay, always fine, always must go on, it will never stop. The show must not go on, but I know it will. I give up. I give up giving up. I am lost. I don't need to be saved, I need to be found. Basically, it's kind of just the same reoccurring thing of, not knowing who you are and feeling. This started when I was about 15 years old. I was in school. I really wanted to do well at school to please my parents. My family, I didn't really care that much about school because I knew I was never going to be very good at it. I think I pushed myself so far, got to the point where I had a bit of a mental breakdown. But I was, just pushing past. So I got to the point where I went a bit mad. I was completely suicidal, didn't want to live anymore. I thought that I was completely alone. I also realized how lucky I was and what a wonderful family, wonderful friends I had, but that didn't matter. I wanted the world to swallow me up, and nothing seemed better to me than death, which is completely insane. So I just got taken out of school, went to therapy, got put on antidepressants, kind of clawed my way back to some sort of rational thought, which took a while. But basically, I stayed in school until I was 17, where I still was kind of playing with this depression, and I was like, I'm done, I need to leave, which to the rather large disagreement from my parents. I left, and I knew I had to do something.